fact-checking round now, the president's comments about a crime that happened in Clayton County. He talked about it during his national address about now a neighbor is facing charges.
Yeah, a pastor had been murdered. The president says the suspect was in the country illegally. 11 Live's Elwin Lopez joins us. The president pointed out, Elwin, that this crime in Georgia backs up his argument for a border wall.
Yeah, that's right, Cheryl. We covered this case in November. Police arrested a man from Mexico named Christian Ponce Martinez. He is charged for the murder of his neighbor, 77-year-old Robert Page.
In Georgia, an illegal alien was recently charged with murder for killing, beheading, and dismembering his neighbor.
We reached out to Page's family today, but they said they cannot talk about the case and were unaware the president was going to mention it. The story generated many responses from you on our Facebook page. Lisa asking whether Ponce Martinez was here illegally. The White House claims he was. We asked the Clayton County District Attorney's Office, U.S. Border Patrol, and ICE about that claim today, but we have yet to get a response. The only thing they said when he was arrested in November was that he had moved to Moro from Mexico 3 months ago. We've reached out to ICE since the government shutdown to get answers on other stories, and the response we received is that, quote, they are out of the office due to the federal funding hiatus. Martinez is still at Clayton County Jail with an ICE hold and without bond. The case coming under scrutiny as the president continues to push to fund a border wall, which has become central dividing point in the government shutdown. President Trump today said he has the absolute right to declare a national emergency if Democrats and Republicans can't reach a deal on border security. Now, 19 days into a government shutdown, a political stalemate all but ensuring 800,000 federal workers will not get paychecks this Friday, with neither side budging.
Last night, the president spat more malice and misinformation, appealing to fear instead of facts. The reality is that the president could end the Trump shutdown and reopen government today.
And coming up at 6, we will answer your questions about what illegal immigration in this country looks like today and the crime linked to those here. In the newsroom, I'm Elwin Lopez, 11 Alive News.
Thank you, Elwin. The conversation online has not slowed down a bit since President Trump ended his speech. The comments reflect a country divided on this issue. Wendy Akerhouse from Facebook says, he's so right. Without a wall, immigration laws will never be effective. A wall is the place to start. But a very different view from Angela Corley. She's asking, why is he holding Americans hostage to fulfill his campaign promise? He said Mexico would pay for the wall. I'm not falling for it. He spreads lies, malice, and misinformation. A lot more of this conversation right now on our 11 Live Facebook.